G'day and welcome back to Duxalla Gaming and our fun Let's Play series on Great Western Farm by Chris Kimball Gaming. So here we are, episode 2, and what we've done is we've skipped across a day, actually 2 days I think, because we had a bit of rain, and we'd also sown all our fields. So let's have a look at the map. So currently we own field 3, field 5, field 2, and turn off the grass so we can see it. Fields G1, G2, and G3 are grass fields. Okay, so after just that first 2 nights, we have our grass is ready to harvest. Now that's never a bad thing. So what we're going to do is we're going to get stuck into some harvesting, and we're going to do it with our favorite tool, the Big M. There should be no surprises with that. So without further ado, let's get over. We'll do the 2 grass fields over here, one adjacent to number 3 and the one here where we are now. And we'll take all the grass down to the biogas and we'll get the BGA up and running. Okay, that's the plan for today's episode. So let's go and get into it. So we'll head over here and grab our Big M, which is in the shed. So, this is going to be, like I said before in the first episode, it's going to be a bit of a fun, oh, the shed, a bit of a fun episode. We're not playing seasons, we're not playing overly serious, sort of back to the vanilla state of the game, and we're just going to see how we go with that. Now, the other advantage is I now have my monitor mounts, and I now have the steering wheel back. So, there's no excuses other than just my poor driving. So I have to get used to it again. It may take some time to get used to it. But we have it back again. So we're not going to tether around the grass here. We're just going to go in and we're just going to cut. We actually start cutting from here. Let's just start from here. There we go. Yeah, so we're just going to cut the grass, and then we'll come through and collect it, and then send it all down to the BGA. We certainly don't need any grass yet for the sheep, so we're all good to go. Alright, so a nice relaxing episode of just mowing some grass. So I didn't think we were necessarily going to get to this point, but that's all good. Nothing wrong with doing a bit of grass mowing. So like I said, this is going to be well, getting back to basics. We're going back, we've got no seasons, we're playing it very, very basic again, which is going to be good fun. I mean, let's not hold back. I mean, seasons is very good. It makes it much more realistic and much harder to play. Whereas this is much quicker. I mean, like I said, 2 nights and we've got a full growth of grass. So it just means we can get stuff done and have a good variety of stuff to do. So, like I say, for instance, this episode we'll probably do some grass. Next episode we might go up and do some forestry. And then come back the next day and we've got all our fields ready to harvest, and we might go harvest some of our fields. So it gives us the flexibility and a lot more variety in a shorter space of time, as opposed to spending 24 days, for instance, waiting for your crops to be ready or part thereof. So anyway, so here we are using the Krone Big M. This is my Duxalla limited edition version, which my good friend Eustace Farmer did up for me, which was a nice surprise. And it is my preferred Big M. There is the new 2017 edition that was put out by LS Mod Company, which I did a review on. Now, it's a little bit smaller. It is far more detailed. The textures in it and all that are fantastic. It actually has the mowing blades. You can actually see the mowing blades in the new one. So the detail is fantastic. The The part that that loses it for me is we don't have the color selection, and also we don't have the extendable hitch, which you see on the back here. Now, the boys at LS Mod Company were saying that they were going for a bit more realism, which is fine. I understand that, and I can't fault them for that. But for my personal liking, and obviously we're going to use stuff that we like to use. We're not going to use stuff that we don't use. It's not that I don't like it. Don't take that the wrong way. It's not that I don't like 2017 edition BM. But I just prefer to have this one and have the ability to change the colours as I see fit. But also having that added flexibility of using the extended hitch to add other attachments on the back end of the Big M to maximise our productivity. So this is our preferred Big M. They are both the same size. They are 13.2 metre cut, same size. Body-wise, it's the new one's a little bit smaller, like I said. But in any case, this is our go-to, it really is. Now, on a recent episode of Beaver Creek, I was mowing grass with my Abomination. The Abomination I haven't got set up on this map as yet. I certainly could do it, and I might do it, noting the fact we've got three nice big grass fields. But we'll just see how we go. We've also got the GTX 550 GD. It's not GTX, what is it? Anyway, doesn't matter. 550 GD, which is the mower and container, so it's sort of the all-in-one unit. We've got that as well, so we could probably do some grass collection with that. But as we said, so this game, getting back to our original topic, this game is not as realistic. However, we are still playing it basically like a career mode. So we're not cheating any more money in. We're not cheating any money in, full stop. Anything we need to buy and that now we have to provide for ourselves. Now, it's not going to be that onerous because of the fact that our crops will be ready like within 3, maybe 4 days. So that's not going to be so much of an issue. But yeah, we're going to play it sort of down the line. And I think in the first episode, I'll have to review just to make sure, and I'll have to write this down. I've got so many Let's Play series running at the moment, I'm not sure what I said. But I think we said that our goal was to get to $25 million accrued. And with the first million, once we get to a million, we're then going to buy $500,000 worth of cows and $250,000 worth of sheep. So that's our first goal, is to get to our million so we can bump up the animals and start looking after some animals. So we'll just have to see how we go. So I don't know how much logging we'll do. We'll probably do a fair bit of logging. There's plenty of trees up there, as you can see on that hill up there. There's plenty of trees around. So we'll probably definitely do some logging. But we'll just have to play it by ear and see how we go. Anyway, I hope you're enjoying the fact that we have the steering wheel back up and running again. It's certainly a lot cleaner to watch. Certainly if I'm in this view. I know previously if I've gone to cab view, not that I'm going to go this way that long because I'm going to miss edges. But normally it'd be sort of shaking about and hitching left and right because the keyboard not being so smooth, obviously. But yeah, so it's nice to have this back up and running, so we're sort of back to running where we should. All right. So the other news is, obviously I'm recording this well before Christmas, as you would know if you've been watching any of my videos up until now. I've done, I think it's about 28 or 29 videos. In the space of about a week, just to get ready for my trip away, because we're going away for Christmas with the family. We're going down to spend Christmas with my family in a different state. So this one's obviously been recorded as well, and this is towards the end of the string of videos. So this will be well and truly after Christmas and New Year's, which of course I hope you all had a Merry Christmas and a wonderful time with your family and friends, and a safe and fun New Year's. But anyway, I still divert from what I was going to get to. But today in the mail, not only did I receive my monitor mounts, which I'll get a photo of at some point, maybe in one of the next episodes I'll display that, but I haven't got it set up for the moment, the photo that is. We received our pen from Jerry, Grizzly Bear Sims' shop on Etsy. I was a little bit worried that we may not have got it before we left, but we did get it, and it is a beautiful thing. I didn't realise that I had got the, I think it's the Bethlehem olive, and I mean Jerry, I'm sorry, I may have got this wrong, but it's from the olive tree or something from Bethlehem, and I've got a certificate of authenticity to say it's a piece of that wood, so which I wasn't aware of. I just saw the pens on the website, and I just saw which one actually looked the best. I didn't actually look at the details of it, and I ordered it. So it arrived today, and it's a lovely pen. It really, really is. It really looks a treat. So thank you, Jerry. It's a great addition to my stationery equipment now, and well, it might be until after Christmas, but yeah, no, beautiful looking pen. So I urge you all to go and check out Jerry's shop on Etsy, or his page on Etsy. I notice he's been doing some cheese boards and stuff like that as well now, so go and check it out. But the pen, I do rate the pen, and I do recommend it, so go check it out. You're obviously supporting a fellow YouTuber, and just a damn good bloke. Ultimately, that's what it comes down to. All right. So we've almost finished this field, and then what we might do is we might actually collect the grass, and then go and dump into the BJ instead of just doing a full episode of mowing. We'll collect what's here and then go and dump it. Certainly probably won't be a full load in our loading wagon, so I think we've got our modded loading wagon, which takes 400,000 litres, so I wouldn't expect it to fill that up, but probably about, I don't know, let's guesstimate about 190,000 litres of grass, thereabouts. We'll soon see. So we're a bit overcast, obviously. It's a bit dreary, today's weather. I'll just have a bit of a look around. Very dreary. It doesn't look good. It looks very gloomy, which is fantastic. I like it. I really do. I keep saying how much I like the atmosphere in this game. And look, I'm not sure if it's entirely Giants that controls the atmosphere and the lighting in regards to what we're looking at now, or whether the modders have a bit of a say in that when they create their maps. But either way, like the look of it, I really do. All right, rest assured though, we won't get any snow, so that's okay. We're only looking at rain, and the other thing is too, obviously with the rain, without seasons, we can still harvest our crops. So, or can we? See, it's that long since I played vanilla, I can't remember. Can we still harvest our crops when it's, I don't think we can harvest them when it's raining, but we don't have a wet crop scenario, so yeah, but anyway. I will have my memory jogged sometime later, I am sure. Or someone may let me know down in the comments. Alright, this should be our last run now. And then we might go and see what we've got available to collect it all. My normal preference now is to go the Fent, the Duxorley Limited Edition Fent Tri-6. I'll have to do a little return run here. And this, what is it, the Strautman? Strautman, is that how you say it? Strautman? Loading wagon, which we have modded. Well, we haven't modded, but it's a modded version. Right, so we'll do this little bit here. And this will be the last run through here. Certainly does make a difference with the steering wheel. I did make a lot of comments about it when I first did get this G27. Now, I happened to be lucky enough to get hold of a second-hand G27, one that had been used for, oh, I swear he probably only got out of the box and used it for about 15 minutes by the look of it. It basically came brand new. It was in mint condition. So I was very lucky to obtain that in that condition, and it's brilliant. And I've seen a lot of write-ups, a lot of people commenting about the fact that the G27 is so much better than what was the process, the G29 and all the newer stuff. So yeah, very happy we've got this one. All right, so we'll just come and park in there. All right, oops. Okay. So now we'll go down and find, what have we got down here? We got a Zerion. Actually, if I actually got a loading wagon, I don't know if I bought a loading wagon. We might be in trouble. No tractors in there. No, I haven't bought a Tri-6. Whoops, that'll be the door. So it's going to be the Zerion. That's okay. All right. Let's see if we've got a loading wagon. We got a manure spreader. I don't think we have. Let's go check. So I don't think we're going to have enough money to buy it. We do. All right. There we go. Talk about take it to the finite. Now, where's our store again? So I've only played this one episode thus far. The store is over there. Okay, we'll go over and click that. Yeah, so now we're really pushing the boundaries. What are we? $825 in the bank. So we need to make some money very quick. How much better is this with the steering wheel? My goodness. And the shop should be just in here. That's right, it's our John Deere shop, isn't it? Let's have a look. Where are we? There he is. Now I got to remember, I did change the the button bindings, because since we last ran the steering wheel, we've had a reload and reinstallation of farming sim, so we had to rebind because some of the keys were totally wrong and totally not where I thought they were. But now I've actually done them again. I've done them probably differently to what I had before, so I've got to relearn what I've put out. And I've just realized as well that on my foot pedals I haven't put down the sticky feet, the little feet that come down that sort of grab into the carpet, and the foot pedals are sliding away from me. That's all right. First world problems. Alright, so we'll head around in here. There we go. Now let's see if I've got the right commands here. There we go. So we can do all this in cab because we've got the fine control and I'm more comfortable with doing it with the steering. Well, it's not that bad to do it with the keyboard when you're collecting up a windrow, so it's not that bad. Okay. But what I did is I pressed the wrong key and I forced it to do an unload here. So we weren't actually collecting anything. Right, so we'll try again. See, I said it's not that hard to actually pick it up. Well, obviously it is. Put on cruise control as I bring my pedals back under control. Alright, so yeah, we'll collect this up and then we'll dash down to the BGA and drop it off and then we'll see what we can do. We might then do our next field with baling it and then selling it off, because obviously not having seasons we can sell our grass and our grass bales, so we can make a bit of a profit that way. So that's an option available to us. Little lights on, light on just to give us a bit extra light on the subject matter, since it's so overcast. But yeah, so this is going to be an interesting mind, the work Chris Kimball's done on his maps. So we're playing two of his maps concurrently, obviously. We're playing this one, Great Western Farm, is it Great Western Farm, I think it was? And his other one being Lost Valley, I think Lost Valley was the first one he came out with, or the one that preceded this one. I stand corrected if I'm wrong. But yeah, they're both very good maps. I'm liking it a lot. The series on Lost Valley obviously is really just sort of non-serious, and we're mucking about with that one. But there's no real rhyme nor reason to what we're doing on there. But other than just playing on the map and just doing our stuff. But yeah, this one in particular, I don't mind this one. We might this series might go on for a little while, because I do enjoy this one. But like I say, I've spent about an extra 15 minutes past the first episode, so I've spent probably about an hour and a half total on this map thus far, and yeah, I'm really enjoying it. So I encourage you to head to his Facebook page and get hold of the map. You won't be disappointed. Alright, so we've got 86,000 already. I think my guess of about 170,000 to 180,000 is going to be way off. So obviously it's good that I'm not an estimator, because my estimations are rubbish. So the other thing is too, having the steering wheel, this pertains basically to my good mate Reefy, is hopefully Reefy, I won't crash too much more. Because a lot of the problems I have with crashing is generally because I can't coordinate the keyboard well enough to slow down or speed up or whatever else. So hopefully you shall take back over the reign of the king of crashes, Reefy. So we'll see how we go. I've got to check out his last couple of videos actually, and I'm going to start doing a tally of the amount of crashes per episode between us, and we'll have a bit of a little competition. But no, I've got a lot of time for Ethan. He does a good job with his videos, and it's always good to have a bit of a muck about with the people you interact with, like Eustace Farmer, who still decides to send me these silly pictures. And no, I'm not putting them up on the video. Children have been warned about these sorts of things. Now, you know, he's got two lovely daughters. I think it's two or maybe three, at least two lovely daughters and a lovely wife. And with the photos he sends me, I don't know. Obviously, Eustace's wife is a lovely and charming and fantastic person to raise two lovely girls, because I don't know what Eustace did to help. But anyway, I'm only joking. I do actually enjoy, if you haven't seen Eustace's latest intro video, he does update them every 2-3 days, so you may have to go and catch an older video to find it. But you got the girls on his intro singing, and also got his wife doing a bit of a overlay in there as well. So it's fantastic. Got a lot of time for his production quality and what he does. So yeah, it's well worth checking out. Just his intro videos are well worth checking out. His content's pretty good too. Bear with me for a second, as I think I've got a spider or something climbing on my leg. Nope. Anyway, it's all right. We'll continue. So I guess the next thing we need to try will be a. I'm going to say this very quietly because I don't want the wife to hear. Is an IR head tracker. So does anyone else use it out there? I know. Actually, no, I don't know who does use it. I think Grizzly might use it. Can't remember. But if you've got one, how do you find it? Is it any good? Is it worthwhile? Let me know in the comments. I think they're only about $150-$200 from what I saw when I looked at them a while back. But that might be a wild underestimate and estimation of the pricing. So yeah, let me know, and I might have to have a look at that in the new year and see how we go. Alright, so we've got 200,000 litres now. So we're probably going to be close to the 250,000 litre mark for this field. So, not too bad. Not too bad at all. So, so what have we got underway? So we've currently got our, as of the time we're doing this video, we still have our 24-day seasons challenge on Sherwood Park Farm, which is a lovely map by my good modding friend, not so much a friend, but I'll take him as a friend because he's a great modder, Stevie. And yes, like Jerry, Grizzly Bear Sims, I do have a man crush on Stevie with his maps and all his mods. Yes, we've got that running. I think about this time when you're watching this, I should be up to about episode 40, thereabouts. And we should be coming into winter, I think, if I remember correctly. We've also got our newish Let's Play series on Black Sheep Modding's latest map, the Valley of the Old Farm. And we're doing a full-on career mode with seasons on that map, which incorporates using smaller equipment, which is something I've never really done. And in particular, we're using components out of the Massey Ferguson pack that Black Sheep Modding developed for the mod contest for 2017. And we're using lower end equipment. We're not jumping straight up and buying. We haven't got a Zerion on the farm. So we do have a big M, but that's as high tech as we go. So yeah, it's a nice challenge. Ooh. Pardon my yawning. Yeah, so we've got that one underway, and I believe at the time of this episode airing, we'll be up to about episode 7 on that series. Then of course we've got this series, the Great Western Farm series, this is our second episode. And then the other one is Lost Valley, again another map by Chris Kimball Gaming, and I think we're on about the second or third episode with that one as well. Just not doing those ones as often as the others. So yeah, but anyway, all right, so we're at about the 30 minute mark now, so there you go, it's 30 minutes to mow the field and then to collect the grass, and we're getting very close to 300,000 litres, so I was miles off. So we'll let the episode run out to dropping it off at the BGA, and we'll sign off when we get down to the BGA basically, and we're offloading. So that would be the plan. I hope you don't mind, but yeah, I know mowing grass isn't for everyone, and I'll probably get the instant dislike by whoever it is that seems to put that out occasionally. That's all well and good, but I like mowing. You know, I'd be quite happy to do a mat full of grass and just mow and bale. Actually, no, I'm not going to bale. No, I'm still broken with bales. Just mow, tether, collect, sell, get sheep going, all that sort of stuff. I'd be quite happy doing that. I know you wouldn't be, but in my own little special world, the Bethel world, I would be more than happy with that. All right. So now what we need to do is get our bearings and go to our biogas. So we need to go back out this way. And head down to the south. Head off out through the track here. Looking at a cap for this trip, just to sort of take in the scenery again of the map. You'll notice we're able to use indicators now too. Yay! No. Not that I couldn't use them before, but more of an imposition going to find the key on the keyboard, all that sort of stuff. So, all right. So again, we've got the waterfall over here on the right hand side. You can see it over there. As I go off the road, over there. Oh, speed wobbles. All right, let's take control of this tractor. There we go. We might do is just to stabilize our, I think our dead zone's a little bit big at the moment. Anyway, that's all right, we've got the speed wobbles. We've the trailer's not real stable when it does get a big load in it. This is our turn off, I think. Is it? Yep. All right. See if we are the biogas in here on the right hand side. I must have turned traffic off on this map. Well, there was no traffic. I can't remember. Anyway, that's all good. All good, all good. So we'll go in here and we'll drop off the grass, and that should start producing some digestate for us, and then. We can come down and start getting our fuel and our fertilizers producing. And there's two sides to this. There's two actual dump points. So make sure we've got that lot. So I'll just accelerate the time a bit as well, so that way it empties out quite quickly. We've made a little bit of money from that, which is always good. So what we'll do is we'll continue to offload our grass here, and in the meantime we will sign off, and we shall see you back here on Great Western Farm sometime in the near future, as we continue to bring in the grass and hopefully start bringing in some of our other crops as well. So this is Duck Zoli at Duck Zoli Gaming, wishing you a wonderful morning, afternoon, evening, night, wherever you are in the world. And until next time we catch up again, take care of yourselves and all others in your family. Thanks very much for watching. See you later. Bye.